Dear organizers, I'm happy to have the possibility to present here in Berlin on this wonderful conference a specific collection of Ethiopic manuscripts. But first of all, I want to thank Dr. Michaela Hofmann-Ruf, the clever coordinator of Galamos, who helped me a lot to get acquainted with the database of Oriental Digital. And sorry for my pronunciation, but I'm going to speak in English because some Ethiopian friends are looking at the presentation and they only speak English and, of course, Amharic and so on. A friend asked me recently, Verena, you are vegetarian, but you are always working with objects made from animals. And I answered, yes, animals disappear eating them, but processed into manuscripts, it is very sustainable. In the next 20 minutes, I will take you to something like a wonderland for each Ethiopianist, Orientalist, and codicologist. You will hear about the work of a current collector, a constantly growing collection, the Ethiopic manuscripts of the collection, and the cataloging process. I am going to hint on efforts within the provenance research on manuscript from Ethiopia too, and will conclude with the possibilities for scientists to study the manuscript in Stützerpach, Thuringia. But please, let me start with the foundation. The foundation Monumenta Vitruvi is located in the Glasischen Haus in Stützerbach, Thuringia. The name Monumenta Vitruvi is a hint to the glass manufacturing in this area, as vitrum means glass in Latin, but also to white, the blood dyeing plant that grew there. Stützerbach is a little place not far from Gotha, the well-known birthplace of Ethiopian studies. Ethiopia and today's Thuringia share a long tradition. In 1534, Martin Luther, together with Melanchthon, interviewed already Abba Mikael, an Ethiopian monk, about the culture, history, and theology of his country. Hiob Ludolf, we heard from him, 1624 to 1704, and Abba Gregorius spent months researching the history, languages, and theology of Ethiopia at Friedenstein Castle in Gorsa. They were invited by Duke Ernst the Pious, a major patron of Oriental studies and Ethiopian studies in particular. Ludolf's work, Historia Ethiopica, and Commentarius ad Suam Historiam Ethiopicam stand for the evaluation of oral and written witnesses. Johann Michael Wansleben and Theodor Petrus continued this in Gotha and Erfurt. The Glasischen Haus, named after Johann Elias Glaser, 1721 to 1781, who built this magnificent frame house, was bought by Dr. Kai Behrmann in 1995 and restored until 2005. It is a merchant house with a bourgeois claim in a place characterized by international relations of the glass industry. Were it first of all the dukes and princes who collected, the bourgeoisie followed and assembled in their homes entire libraries and natural science collections. Some called it Cabinet of Curiosity or Naturalienkammer. The Belle Etage in the Glasischen Haus proves this. After years of restoration, the interiors were able to be purposefully renovated and house the foundation's collection. The foundation Monumenta Vitruvi was established in 2009 by Dr. Kai Behrmann. Its purpose is focusing on the relationship between Germany and Ethiopia and the acquisition of books and manuscripts and to make them available to the public and professional audience. Step by step, Dr. Kai Beermann is transferring his private collection of books and manuscripts to the foundation. The collection includes about 2,500 manuscripts, incunabula and early prints. The focus of the collection is on Ethiopia, the relation between Ethiopia and Europe, and the related currents of thought until 1806. Icons, crosses, and everyday objects complement the writings. The Glasershin Haus in Stützerbach is known in the area. Often hikers pass by or visitors of the nearby Goethe Museum. But it is rare for experts to come and look at the Ethiopica. In accordance with the title of our conference, I can give here a small insight into the antique trade across the globe, especially the trade with the Ethiopic manuscripts. But first, I would like to introduce the collector. Normally, a collector is deeply researched only after his death. But here we have the chance to meet the collector, to interview him, and to accompany the growing collector. Dr. Kai Beermann was born in 1963 in Essen. He studied dentistry and became a dentist. Books have been important for him since childhood. When he was 9, he bought The Story of Dr. Doolittle by Hugh Lofting with his pocket money. Since then, he was fascinated from the world of books. He is very athletic and participated in the Rennsteiglauf in Thuringia in 1990, which is how he got to know Stützerbach. In 1991, he started with the professional collecting. In 1991, the wonderful library of the castle Reifersteit Duc was dissolved. The auction house Veneta and Hanstein in Cologne was commissioned, and he purchased some old books. 1992, he traveled to Turkmenistan, where he got to know Martin Pischel. Martin Pischel told him every day that in Ethiopia, everything is much better. They decided to travel together to Ethiopia. 1994, he visited for the first time Ethiopia and Eritrea and was fascinated. Together with Martin Pischel and his Yesfaya Mengistu, they traveled from Asmara to Addis Ababa by the route you can see here on the map. Since then, he had been 6 times in Ethiopia and 1 time in Eritrea. He visited many churches and monasteries, but it was in Aksum, the significant city in Ethiopia, where the Ark of Covenant is located, that Dr. Beermann bought his first manuscript in a bookshop. It was a Saint's Vita of Gebre Memphis Gedus, called Gedle Memphis Gedus. Immediately, he decided to focus on this collection area. Professor Bruns, University of Eichstätt, now University of Bamberg, taught him Goes, Old Ethiopic, in the 1990s. And Dr. Beermann still can read some parts in this ancient language. A small but very active society, the Tabor Society, played an important role. Dr. Kai Beermann was a member of this society, founded by Professor Dr. Friedrich Heyer. The association supports Ethiopian church schools located around Gondar, a city near Lake Tana. Dr. Beermann visited the supported church schools. At once was also given a manuscript by a doctor of the church, which fellow travelers can testify to. And you see him here. It was Lika Lika und Meme Mekonnen from the Metame Alem Church School in Gondar. Dr. Beermann provided a special experience for Ethiopian Bishop Abuna Elias, responsible for the church schools sponsored by the Tabor Society, on his visit in Germany. He arranged a mine tour at a depth of 1,000 meters in a mine in Essen. The report in the Society's newspaper describes the encounter, including Abuna Elias' refusal to give up his hand cross going down into the earth. And this was the starting point for Dr. Behrmann to collect Ethiopian crosses too. Dr. Behrmann's extensive knowledge of history and his erudition helped him to assemble his collection in terms of incunable and first editions, mentioning here Breidenbach in the travelogue of Francisco Alvarez. He attends as guest conferences of Ethiopian studies, like the conferences of Orbis Ethiopicus. There he got to know Professor Raunig, director of the Völkerkunde Museum Munich, now named Museum of the Five Continents. Orbis Ethiopicus organized conferences, and Dr. Behrmann attended and could hear more research results in relation to Ethiopian manuscripts. He got in contact with Atto Görmer Fissea. The late Görmer Fissea was a curator of the Ethiopian sector in the museum. I mention him here because he was the expert for many manuscripts on the market, and he evaluated some of the manuscripts for Dr. Behrmann. Besides the two societies mentioned here, he has contact to the medical mission sisters in Addis Ababa. Dr. Behrmann is always interested in the latest projects and research results. He is well informed about all events in Ethiopia and Eritrea. Recently, he told me that due to the civil war in Ethiopia, he had heard that manuscripts from Tigray, this is a province in Ethiopia, should be on the market. But this was a fake news, and he could not ascertain this due to his knowledge of the auctioneers' houses. This leads us to the point where Dr. Behrmann bought his huge amount of Ethiopian manuscripts. The collector acquired the Ethiopian manuscripts in different ways. He got some in Ethiopia, but 90% of his manuscripts he bought outside Ethiopia. He bought many manuscripts from private individuals. During the conference, he met a lot of people, and they offered him their books and manuscripts for sale. The same is true for relatives who found manuscripts in their estate and did not want to keep them. In the 90s, he acquired so several bundles of manuscripts. Sorry. Dr. Behrmann uses the web for his research. Through eBay or eBay Kleinanzeigen, he already bought some manuscripts. Before buying, he calls the seller and asks for details. Once the purchase had been made, he almost always collects the manuscript in person. Even if it is far away, he drives there. Too many things can happen when you send manuscripts by the German post. In a few cases, the collector had an expert opinion of the manuscripts drawn up in advance by Atto Görmer Fissea. Dr. Behrmann does not know personal other collectors of Ethiopica, but he knows the relevant antiquarian bookshop and auction houses in the World Wide Web. There he occasionally exchanges ideas with other collectors. He bought most of the manuscripts from antiquarians, either in person on site, according to catalog, or online after the introduction of e-commerce. From 1995 until 2010, he was a regular customer by Sam Falk in London. He offered excellent Ethiopic manuscripts, but in 2010, Sam Falk gave up this field. Dr. Behrmann follows the auctions mainly in England. There are still many Ethiopic manuscripts in private hands. I just mentioned here the Magdala collection, but we are going to hear on this tomorrow or on Friday. The search engines and auction houses like Via Libri, Lotissimo and Salesroom or Christie's, Beinecke or Ketterer are constantly combed by him. He makes a bid by telephone. According to him, this is better than written offers, as there are also unprofessional houses. He then waits for the bill and then drives up to pick up the newly purchased Ethiopian manuscript. Receives approvals are available for these purchases. The documentation of acquisition is an important part of each collection. Also more so as his private collection, as a private property, is transferred into the capital of the foundation Monumenta Vitruvi. The German tax office is well known for its comprehensive control of the ownership and general benefit of foundations. It can be noted here, the collection was not built up systematically, but rather randomly according to what was currently on offer on the market. And yet it is precisely in this way that the foundation collection has become one of the most significant collections in Germany. Collection history is one of the major research topics due to the awareness of the connection between imperial claims to power and the transfer of the material scriptures from the East to the West, from Orient and Africa to Germany. To analyze the past from the point of view of the current state of knowledge is an accurate process. The haze of the past lies over it. But how to deal with the collection history of a newly built collection? It is a great fortune for research and to be able to be so close to current events here. The collection is one of the most expensive private collections of Ethiopic manuscripts and was created in the last 30 years, making it one of the youngest collections in Europe. Within the 2,500 objects of the collection, 300 manuscripts and parchment scrolls from the 15th to the 21st centuries in Gös, Old Ethiopic, Amharic, Tigrinya, Arabic and Harari are now, sorry. Are now getting into the database. Most of the manuscripts belong to the canon of the Ethiopian Orthodox Tewahedo Church, which has been the core church since the 4th century. The two oldest manuscripts are a Tetra Evangelii and a Psalter and can be dated to the first half of the 15th century. Bible manuscript, Beluina Hadis Gidan, Psalteries, David, Saint Vines, and the calendar compilation of the legends of saints, Synchisar, Marian writings like the miracles of Mary, Te Amre Mariam, or Wadasse Mariam, theological and liturgical tracts like the homily of the archangel Raguel, Der Sane Raguel, or the anaphora of Mary, Kedasse Mariam, prayer rolls, national epic, Cabrinagist, and royal chronicles are carriers of the Ethiopian textual tradition. It can be stated already here that the collection has an example of every period of the Ethiopian manuscript tradition. Of value are also the uniquely handed down Mitzrafe Tergwame and Andemta, exegetical works of the famous Ethiopian doctors of the church, which comment on the Bible, church fathers, and liturgical writings. At least one third of the manuscripts are illuminated. Two examples you can see here. It is a homiliary of the archangel Michael and a gospel book. Only a few of the manuscripts are not written on parchment, but on paper. Around 30 Ethiopian Islamic manuscripts are in Arabic or Harari and include Korean exegesis and hadiths. The cataloging of these books or booklets is still upcoming. Six of the manuscripts have been restored at the Colonial Institute of Conservation Science. The restoration was documented and will be exhibited in the future. Actually, 20 pages with miniatures of the miracles of Mary are restored by Ms. Hassel in Frankfurt. It is a growing collection through further acquisition. Becoming in spring 2021, I started to catalog the contents. We decide that I will start with the codices and use the order numerus currens. The scrolls will follow afterwards. The structure of the database of Orient Digital or Alamos defines which information I should provide of each manuscript. For the database, we choose as signature Monumenta Vitruvi Mon Point Vitre Point. Ethiopia is an African country. Nevertheless, the category Christian Orient is used for Ethiopian objects and therefore for the manuscripts. In Alamos, we continue classifying them as Christian Orient and therefore belonging to the category Oriental. Manuscripts in Kiswahili or Wolof are defined by codicology as African, but not Ethiopian. Why? Of course, it is a Eurocentric colonial discourse, but also a theological. As the five national churches of Armenia, Coptic, Egypt, Ethiopia, Syria, and India are named Oriental Orthodox churches or non-Chalcedonian churches. The discourse how to categorize Ethiopic manuscripts is actually very intense. Sorry, I have to go back. Some manuscripts are kept in their maada, a shoulder bag or leather case consisting of a slipcase with a flap and carrying strap. Each maada is made specially for the manuscript so that the owner can easily carry it. Therefore, the maada is a collection differ in size and material and form an object of investigation. Boards are covered with red brownish leather and reaches into the inner part of the binding. Most of them are decorated. Just a couple of examples will have to suffice. Here I would like to present two manuscripts that provide insight into the collection. This manuscript was dated to the 15th century by an expert of an auction houses. It is the oldest manuscript of the collection so far. It contains the 151 Psalms of David in the Ethiopian reading. This manuscript does not contain the Canticles, the Song of Solomon, and the Hymns of the Virgin, usually put together in the manuscripts of S. Psalter called Mizmuri David. This Psalter is of particular interest for the research as it contains only the Psalms, but with some explanations called Tergwame. And of course, because of the scribal practice, the layout and the paintings. This Psalter is illuminated with six miniatures painted in the colors yellow, green, red, and white, some with an additional frame in red and blue. Another title for this book, Aude Negist, or Cycles of the King, is Mitzhafebar, Book of Lakes, after the method of which it is used. It is a compilation of divinatory text. The 16 circular charts of the Aude Negist built a manual for diviners and compilers of the prayer scrolls, until recently called magic scrolls or talisman. But in Ethiopic studies, we call it now prayer scrolls. Special learned man, the Deptera, would transcribe such a treatise for his own use or for a customer. The calendaril calculations are an aid for the fortune telling process. Provenance research for Ethiopian manuscripts isn't easy and could be for each manuscript an own research project. Nevertheless, I try to gather the information given in the manuscripts themselves as names of the owner or scribers are written down. Often they are erased and overwritten. The provenance of the manuscripts of private purchase in the past and present is difficult to trace. It requires a provenance recording of each individual manuscript, which is very time consuming. This also applies to the Monumenta Vitruvi collection. At this point, however, it should be noted that the path of the manuscript into the collection is transparent, but not the path from Ethiopia into the hands of the respective antiquarian bookshop or private collection. In most cases, the merchants had no information on the original or temporal origin of the manuscript, which monastery or church, which region in Ethiopia, which epoch, and its way to Europe. However, a colonial provenance can be ruled out, as Ethiopia was the only African country never colonized. Italy occupied it for 6 years and robbed numerous cultural qualities during this time, including manuscripts, and during the British exhibition Magdala and the German Axum exhibition, manuscripts were officially purchased, but today most of them are in libraries and catalogued, like here in Berlin. Conclusion. I will continue to the cataloging process. The digital record of the content and the codicological features is like an identity brand to the collection. The next step is the digitizing of all or at least selected manuscripts. The collection of Ethiopic manuscripts is still growing. Other manuscripts will be bought by Dr. Kai Berman and access to the foundation. The access to the manuscripts is possible by contacting Dr. Berman or the foundation. Some of the manuscripts were part of the Ethiopian exhibition in Frankfurt or the Grassi Museum in Leipzig. Other parts of the collection were already shown in the exhibition in Stützerbach. The manuscripts and other items will be exhibited in showcase in the Glasserschen Haus in Stützerbach in Thuringia. I have a lot of fun working with the manuscripts, and I'm grateful to be able to be so close to the